Greetings, minions. I am your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways. And I'm just here after having taken a bit of a... I just took a bit of a week off. It's not been reflected in my upload schedule, but in terms of recording, I just took a bit of a week off. Tell you for why, because my good friend Lara, who is the only other moderator on my channel's Discord server, she came around and she was staying with me for about a week. Just went home earlier today. And because she was here, I decided to not record anything, decided to spend all my time hanging out with her. So, yeah, took a bit of a week off, took a bit of a week break, and I decided, you know what, I decided that now that, you know, she literally went home earlier today, I decided, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna ease myself back into recording by starting a brand new fucking Let's Play, because that's definitely not actually one of the hardest things to do in my recording. The beginning definitely isn't one of the hardest things to do. Anyway, just gonna start this Let's Play here. If you haven't been able to figure out by now, which, well, you should be able to tell by the title, but there isn't actually a title on the screen, but the title of the video gives it away. This is a Let's Play of Dead Rising, specifically Dead Rising 1 on their PC. Yep, the PC port of Dead Rising 1. Some of you may recall that I attempted, I believe, Dead Rising 2 off the record some time ago. Got, I think, a fair way through the game, but ultimately didn't complete it. In that Let's Play, cancelled that because I got into a bad spot. That is not likely to happen here. Oh, yep, there comes the title, and I'll tell you for why. Two essential reasons. The first of which is that the original Dead Rising, more than any other game in the series, is my favourite. Though I enjoy Dead Rising 2 and Dead Rising 2 off the record, and Dead Rising 3 can go fuck itself, and Dead Rising 4 can literally go fuck itself as hard as is physically possible, I adore Dead Rising 1 more than the rest of them. It's genuinely a series where I think the first one just got it right, and then the subsequent ones were tinkering unnecessarily with a format that already worked, and therefore ended up being inferior products. I played this a lot. It's my favourite in the series. I played this a whole holy heck of a lot. Indeed, I'd say that Dead Rising 1 is one of my favourite video games of all time. I remember I bought it back when it first came out. I was really excited, got the Steelbook, went home, like literally picked up the Steelbook edition for the 360 on my way home from school, and then just played this and nothing but this for a very long time. Got almost all of the achievements back then, but that was many years ago. So I'm fairly familiar with the game. I'm also more familiar with the game, because if we go and start game here, you'll see, Thick Pig Dad. Yep, in slot number one, I've already got 72-hour mode, overtime mode, and infinity mode, and, you can see there, I've actually been playing a save on day 3 there. This save is actually explicitly, that was explicitly me just gathering survivors there, because while Lara was here, she was quite interested in this game, so she asked that I play it for her, so we kind of played it together, me playing, her watching, and us both taking the piss, and I have actually recently completed it, and I'm already max level, so we're not going to run into the issue we had last time with Off the Record. So that's also actually by way of warning, me showing you that this is a Let's Play from max level, so I'm not going to be leveling up over the course of it. I will say also that I do not claim to be a fucking expert at this game at all. It's been a long time since I was good at this. And we are going to be focusing almost entirely on the storyline, though we will make some efforts to save as many survivors as possible, but we're probably only going to get the ones that have scoops. Right, let's go 72-hour mode. Gotta put the controller on my lap there so I don't accidentally skip any cutscenes, as I did a lot. Sorry if you can hear my fan going, it is still incredibly fucking hot here. Oh, and of course, our Frank West is going to be starting in a costume, of course. Because, of course, this is an already played Frank West. I'm hoping this is going to have one of my favourite animations in it. It's like one thing he does, which is like, yep, he's doing it. He's bald there, he's got interesting sunglasses. Because Lara realised I could make him look a bit like Maximilian Strauss in Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, so we're like, yeah, let's dedicate to this.
Something about research for a story.
That's right. Got a tip that something big's happening.
In a nowhere little town like that? They sure didn't mention anything about it on TV.
Yeah, well, I'm freelance, pal. I don't make my living waiting for the TV to tell me what to cover.
Hey, really looks peculiar with that, with those sunglasses on. Not him, Frank.
There she is.
There it is. Okay.
Colorado. Population 53,594. Distinguishing characteristics? Jack shit. About the only thing to do in this town is kill time at the shopping mall. What was that? The army? Yeah.
Looks like taking a helicopter was the way to go. I bet they got all the roads blocked off by now. All right, listen. I want to get shots of the whole town before the National Guard finishes roping it off. Take me over the main street.
Okay, and there was introduced our dear Frank West, and there, of course, is what he's supposed to look like before I Maximilian Straussed him. Right, let's have ourselves a brief looky-loo and try to remember what the hell the camera controls are. Yep, thank you, game. Though, of course, we don't need any of the PP that we're going to get from this. We'll take the photos anyway, because PP means literally nothing to us. I also don't know what PP stands for. Prestige points? I have no fucking clue.
What is that? Some kind of riot?
Get that picture there. Lovely. I mean, I might as well. Yeah, yeah. I mean, he's not having a good time, pretty clearly. This is a man who ain't gonna do too great. Honestly, he's a bit shit at fighting zombies, is what I'm realizing. You know what I mean? Just a little. Because he didn't actually kill any of them, he just twatted them with a bat and then promptly,
No way.
Well, this is happening to him.
Look at all those people! What the hell's happening here?
Do you know what I mean? Like, that's... It's not a good way to go, if we're being completely honest. It's not a good way to go. Really? This isn't business as usual. Personally, I think this is literally the most normal anything has ever been. I mean, this is basically what it's like every Sunday in my town. Although, granted, these are less zombies, more OAPs, but it's not too far off. OAPs pressing up against the glass of a very specifically American school bus. That's what happens in the English town I've grown up in. Grown up and still live in. Oh shit, man! Scallops! Oh wait, that's not scallops, it's a fucking painting company. It was me thinking we were gonna get some fucking scallops by taking that picture. Oh dear. What? Hickories. Hickory smoked moustache. Fuck me, running.
Did you see that?
No, I didn't. I was looking at hickory smoked moustaches, I'm afraid. Don't fucking speak for me, Frank. We did not see this. We turned around when we heard an explosion. Don't fucking talk on my behalf, Frank. Just because you're the protagonist doesn't give you these fucking rights. You're the protagonist, mate, but I'm the more important P. I'm the fucking player. You know what I mean? You can say whatever the fuck you want, sure, but you know what? I'm still gonna make you act like a fucking asshole. The CW factory there. I was trying to think of a joke about CW, but it didn't go too well, that one. Hi there, love. How you doing? Really doesn't look like you're having a good time. Also, looks like you're not particularly good at figuring out how to get past zombies, is what I'm seeing there, because you also don't seem to have figured out to shoot them in the head yet. All of that won't help. Love behind you. Yeah, a bit grim that. Will any more fall off, or?
take me there.
Nah, it doesn't look like... Well, we're fading to black, so presumably not. Good old Frank, he's an adventurous sort, though. He's also really... Fuck. Sorry, I'll shut up.
You're a reporter, aren't you?
Yeah. No.
You... came alone?
Yeah, I'm freelance. You know, go on the battlefield alone. No crew. So, what's going on around here anyway?
You came by helicopter, didn't you? What did you see from the sky?
Well... if it were just a riot, I doubt the military would quarantine the entire area. The moratorium on information getting out is a little... extreme, in my opinion. There's, something else I can't put my finger on. Doesn't sound like civil disobedience. It's too quiet.
Almost as if everyone's already dead.
Yeah. So why don't you just tell me already? What's going on?
I think you'd better see for yourself. This, my friend, is hell.
You know, it's almost as if, right? It's almost as if Capcom, for some reason, has, shall we say, issues. Is time actually running right now? I don't know. Shit, time is running, okay. But it's almost as if... it's almost as if Capcom has issues... with Hispanics. Do you know what I mean? It's almost as if Capcom doesn't trust Hispanics. Sometimes. Ah, cool. Actually, yeah, there's a thing. In the original Dead Rising on the Xbox 360, you had one save slot and that was it. You couldn't even have multiple characters. It's kind of... honestly, part of the charm for me, I always thought, because it had the... it very much was kind of dedicated to the fact that, no, you are trying to survive this world. You know, fucking give it your all. Do you know what I mean? Like, you're trying to survive here, it's gonna be hard. So I always kind of liked that. In fact, this aspect of this game, if you don't know, as with the other Dead Rising games, this game was very much kind of like a proto... very much like a proto-roguelike, as it were, because it has this issue of... yeah, you don't necessarily have to, like, have a permadeath when you die. You can load back, but the game is very much built around the idea that you will die and then you will restart, but you will bring all of your stats and pictures with you that you've saved, so you can actually just get shit easier. There's one very specific challenge, I think, where...
If I go through here, you can actually see I have... I'm going to go through and delete some of these later, actually. But I have several pictures here that are just... that are, like, protected for reasons. Big ol' spoiler picture, that. But are protected for reasons. Because if you get these in one save, you can... Because if you get these in one save, you can literally reuse them later on. You can reuse them later on. It's pretty fabulous. But yeah, I'll go through and delete those later on, the ones I don't need. Just so... Because they can show up, so I'll try and avoid any... Keep any specific spoilery ones away. It has this kind of proto-roguelike thing going on, which I always enjoyed. I've always been a fan of New Game Pluses. And this game is, like, basically built around the concept of New Game Pluses. Though it does lack a New Game Plus aspect I always enjoyed. Which is the idea that the game changes. The game's always the same in Dead Rising, but there you go. This is a very arcadey, very distinctly gamey game, which is, I think, one of the reasons I enjoy it. Because I feel that, like, as time's gone on, very distinctly gamey games have, like, kind of stopped appearing. Like, it's almost as if, like, distinctly gamey games have kind of fallen out of fashion, or at least these kind of big-name games have kind of fallen out of fashion. Also, we move at a speed that is ludicrous compared to the initial running speed. Even though there are only three levels of speed, and you start with one dot in speed, yeah, this is kind of psychotic. Also, the game lets you do this, which is always fun. You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a ragged baby, round, 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 round. Okay. Every time I start up this game, I'm kind of amazed that a lawyer for George A. Romero doesn't, like, suddenly appear and start screaming about Dawn of the Dead. Yeah, I fucking hate that old woman. Hello, woman who is dressed suspiciously in the exact same color palette as the guy we were just talking to upstairs. Ah, fuck Christ!
No time to ogle pretty girls, son. You looking to get yourself eaten alive by zombies?
What? Did you just say zombies?
Take a look out there. If those ain't zombies, what would you call them?
Yeah, no, pretty solid argument. Those are definitely zombies. Yeah, you got me there.
More of them since last night. Now they're all that's out there. Eh, look on the bright side. Zombies are stupid and slow. We should be safe in here. All right then. Feel like making yourself useful? Take a look around the mall. Bring anything we can use for the barricade back here. Andale! Come on, pronto!
And thus begins the lovely tradition of the cutscenes in this game, where Frank West here will quite literally take photos of everything and everyone. Now, it just occurred to me, there's something I want to quickly check. Okay, I'll go looking. Also, should say, sorry if like, the game is a bit... Sorry if the audio's a bit peculiar in this episode. I'm trying... This game's, like, quite quiet, so I can't just set it on the same, like, low-volume setting I tend to put these games on. So, I'm having to experiment with a volume setting to figure out exactly what's, like, a reasonable volume setting. Dixie and Lawrence since 1871. I mean, this mall hasn't existed since 1871. Streamer! So, this watch plays a lot of League of Legends, does it? Okay. Sorry, I'm like 12. We all know this. I'm 12 with a beard. I'm sorry, it's just a simple fact. Yeah, grab the bin. Do it, you big fucking beefy human being.
You.
Of course, you see.
Stop right there. Do you have any idea what you've done? Why did you summon me to this place? What are you planning?
Would you calm down? I don't even know what you're talking about. What the?
What a bloody peculiar decision. To just randomly take pictures of a crotchety old man who's on the other side of a... Ugh.
What are you thinking?
Oh, no. Get off! Wait, baby! I'm saving you, baby! Wait for me, sweetie!
That one, old woman, is one of history's greatest monsters.
Run! Quick! Move! Get over here! Everyone, move this way! Quick! To the stairs! Move!
Yeah, we've got a problem. But yeah, that one old woman, one of history's greatest monsters. The whole Willamette issue wouldn't have occurred were it not for her. So I'm trying to activate a stupid ability I have. Damn it, the game's not letting me. Ah, I can do this one anyway. Chuck. And somehow that gave me PP. Also, don't worry about these people. You can't fucking save them. These people are basically doomed to die. It's sad but true. They exist only to die. Yep, thank you, game. I know how the controls work. You know, that woman and a fucking black-eyed demon dog literally caused the entire Willamette Mall incident. Had she not done that, as far as I can tell, this mall would genuinely be safe as fucking houses. Which is peculiar, because that does mean that they're, like, literally just, at least it's heavily implied, that there literally just weren't zombies in here until then. That they all came through the entrance, which is equally peculiar because the entrance is also sealed off.
Where are the others?
I don't know. I hope they got away.
I mean, they just didn't.
As long as those things are in the mall, we'd better not use this door.
What are you doing?
The air ducts. They'll get us back into the mall, and apparently those things aren't smart enough to use the ducts. So they won't be a factor.
Wait a minute. You want to get back in there? What for? Hey,
hello.
Nice camera. Are you a photographer?
As a matter of fact, I am. Frank West, photojournalist.
Could you show me some pictures, Frank?
You really seem to know what you're doing. Who are you guys, anyway? And what are you... I took that one near the entrance. That guy do something?
Nope. Thanks for showing me, though.
You know, I make jokes about my friend Lara not having an upper lip, but this woman just genuinely doesn't have an upper lip.
Just who are you guys?
I'm Jesse. The man you saw earlier is Brad. That's all I'm authorized to tell you.
You know, that phrasing isn't particularly good. Because that, especially when you're talking to a journalist, do you know what I mean? If you tell a journalist, I'm not authorized to tell you anything else, what you've done, what you've gotten there now, is a journalist who's definitely going to find out who the fuck you are. Do you know what I mean? Like, he's definitely, he's just going to do it. Right, let's head out on the rooftop. Oh, good, lovely old Otis. I'm not going to read out this dialogue, of course, here. We need to take the transceiver. Yep, good old Otis. A man who you both end up kind of liking and kind of hating, because he is, simultaneously incredibly useful, the character you actually technically interact with the most, and, yeah, also a massive fucking annoyance as well. For reasons that'll become clear. You've seen, if you've seen Dead Rising 2 off the record, you'll recall that we had an earpiece in that game to, accept calls. Not in this one. We have a walkie-talkie. It causes issues. It causes issues, shall we say.
Hey, anybody around?
Okay, so as with the other Dead Rising games, this game is kind of equally split into two halves, those halves being following the story and rescuing survivors. Personally, my favorite thing to do in Dead Rising was always, weirdly, it was always rescuing the survivors. Yeah, basically all the time I loved just rescuing the survivors, which is odd because, you know, it kind of turns the game into escort quests. Which is why I would often play the game in such a way that what I'd do, yep, set, yep, just the controls to call on survivors there. But what I'd do is I would literally just let the main cases, which if I, yep, go, I can't access the case file yet, I don't have it, but actually, let the main storyline stuff, expire, so I can't actually do that, and literally just focus on, doing the side missions and the, saving these people. Of course, the photographs, I will be taking photographs, of course, over the course of the game. Not gonna level up, of course, but, I will take the photographs either way. Right, can we break it up, you two? Because, kinda got shit to do. Yeah, thanks, Natalie and Jeff. Let's fucking go, shall we? You okay there? Yeah, you're okay. Oh, dearie me. Dearie me, dearie me. But yeah, we're gonna be spending a lot of the game literally just dragging people who, I'm gonna say are basically almost universally fucking idiots. I think in the entire time I played this game, there was one there was one survivor that I liked, and he was a fat dude called Wayne. And that's just because that dude knew how to swing a battle axe. The rest of the survivors tend to be thick as pig shit. Yeah. Which, you know, to a degree you can kind of understand, but really, you kind of want, you want better than that. Okay, so what we're going to do is, oh, actually, yep, we're going to grab ourselves this coffee creamer. Some nice big, big fucking health boosts here. I'm going to quickly have a sleep before we head into the mall proper, because that, ladies and gentlemen, is gonna have to be, run save too, yeah. That is gonna have to be all from me for now. I've been your humble narrator, Uncle Sideways, and, well,
what's
bye. Happened? Is it done? Okay, cool, so, I'm just gonna quickly tell you about some links in the description. Not gonna take up too much of your time, because you've probably got other things to do and other videos to watch, so, in the description there, you're gonna find a link to my Patreon, if you wanna support the channel, support me, feel free to, you know, click that link and help me out down there. You'll also find a link to my Discord server, where I talk a lot of bullshit and occasionally play games with folk, so maybe go down there, follow, join that Discord, let's have a chat, you guys, let's have a bit of an old chin wag, and you'll also find my Twitter, where I occasionally post dumb things. I think that's about it. Yeah, so I'm gonna go away now. Bye.